Welcome back to onestoptutorials.com. Alibaba is here again. Okay, we got a lot to do in this tutorial. Hopefully we can get it done in one, but it's probably going to take two. What we want to do is we want to now get into our search bar. Now, this search bar is going to be a little bit more complicated because what we're going to have to do is insert some search script as well, and I'll show you how to do it. But the first thing we want to do is inside of our left content area, which is here, we want to add the search. Okay, now as I explained in a few other tutorials, this is the whole of the left content area. So if we want to add something inside of this left content area, we've got to put it in between the opening div left content and the close. Okay, so we've got to stick it in here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to make another div ID, and you're going to be so professional at the end of this, and I want to call this one search. Okay, again, you can name this anything you want, but for the sake of this, I'm just going to call it search, and I'm just going to close it there. But we're going to come in a minute and add some code. So let's quickly, while we're here, let's quickly, hit enter. As I made an ID, always starts with a pound sign, and I called it search. Okay. So what do I actually want to do with this? Well, what I want to do is, first, I want to specify the size. And this search bar, if you click on the search bar in the one that the original Photoshop template, if you click on it, you'll notice in the page properties, it tells us the width and height, 194 and 56. So that's what I'm going to put into CSS. So the width was 194 pixels. And the height is, what was it again? I think it was 56, wasn't it? 56 pixels. And do you know what I need to do? I need to call in that background image, that actual search bar that we made. So anytime you call in a graphic in CSS from your computer, you just name it background, URL, and let's find that folder. And what do we call it? We called it search. Hit OK. And I'm quickly going to add a no repeat because I know I don't want to repeat this. Okay, so let's go in and have a look, see how we're looking. Come into the design view, and there is our search box. And here is the box that we made. Now, you can see the problem that we got here. It's too far up. It's too far to the left. Very easy to fix that is just we're going to add some margin. Margin's like padding. Margin. Okay, and I'm going to do my four coordinate because I love it. 10 pixel from the top, I want 0 from the right, 0 from the bottom, and I'm going to move it in 10 pixels from the left as well. Let's come and have a look, and there you go. We've added our 10 pixels at the top, no pixels at the right, no pixels at the bottom, 10 pixels at the left, and that has now moved things in. So now we're going to get into this a little bit more difficult stuff, okay? What I want to do is I'm going to use a search form, okay? And I'm just going to copy and paste this in. I'm going to upload this to this lesson folder on my website so you can come in and get this actual script. But what this form is Google form. Google search form, okay? That's what we're going to use. You can use other form of search forms. You're just going to have to probably download something to connect it to, but I'm just going to use Google search because it is a good way of generating some revenue via Google AdSense. So all I'm going to do is paste it in, and this is the Google search code. Now, it might look a little bit different, but to be honest, there isn't a lot of difference between this and the one you'll probably download, okay? So this is what it is. You've got the form action. This is the whole of the form, the opening form, the close of the form, okay? And the action is going to go to my website and a page called search.html. This rest of this input type is what Google give you. This is your pub number and stuff like that. The next one, this is the actual white box, you know, the actual fill out your information box. And this is the submit button. So let's have a look what is happening. And you can see that we're looking a little bit not so good, okay? We got this ugly submit button, and our white box area is way up to the left, okay? So what I'm going to do quickly is I'm going to do a few things. What we need to do is go back to Photoshop and the template that we were working on, okay? I want to, because we forgot to slice up the go button, and in fact, I forgot to slice it up because it's easier to come back in again and get it then actually slice it up and work with the CSS. So I'm going to come to the crop tool inside of Photoshop, and I'm just going to crop this button, and I'm going to zoom in a bit because it's going to be easier for me to select this button a bit better. Just going to move that out, move that in, looking good. Once your selection's made, double left click, it will put it in a new window, and now we can quite simply file, save for web, and I'm just going to hit save. Don't need to optimize it, and I'm going to type this go, Okay, and there we go. We've just added that go button to our folder. So that's the first thing done. The next thing we want to do is we need to start actually applying a little bit of style to this, okay? So what I want to do is, if you inside of Dreamweaver in the design view, you'll notice there is a red line that goes around everything that is your form. This is the whole of your form, okay? Form, action, and it closes here. Well, I want to actually modify that to put it in, to make it basically the same size as our actual search box. Now to do this, I need to do like any other thing is, I need to add an ID to the form. So at the end of where it says onestoptutorials.com search, at the end of the last two quotation marks here, just simply hit space on your keyboard, and we're going to add an ID, okay, like we do with a div, and then we're going to do is name that ID, and I'm just going to name it form, okay? There we go. So we've added an ID to the whole form. So when we come into our actual CSS, we know anytime we make an ID, div ID or whatever ID, it starts with a pound sign and then the name that we named it. So what I want to do is I want to make it the same size as the actual search bar, because we got the graphic in, we might as well keep the whole form inside of that graphic. Okay, so we know what it is. We know the width is 194 pixels, and we know the height is 56 pixels because it says it exactly above this one. Okay, and let me close that, and there we go. This is the width and the height of the search. It's exactly the same. So let's come back in. It won't actually look like we've done much, but what we've basically done is you can now notice that that red line is exactly inside this div. So anything that we move now will be moving inside of this div. That is good stuff. So what do we want to do next? Well, basically what we want to do next is I want to modify this submit button. I don't like these ugly submit buttons, okay? I like adding our own, and it is actually in Photoshop and in Dreamweaver, sorry. It is actually quite an easy process to do. What I'm going to do is if I click on the submit button and I come to the code, you'll notice that this whole bottom area here is the submit button, okay? This is just a bog standard submit button. What I'm going to do is I've got some code here, and I'm going to add my own code to it, and I'm going to paste it underneath so you can actually see what we're doing. So this is the code that they give you. This is just the bog standard submit button code. This is our code, okay? Now it's a bit same. It's the input type name is the same. The type, okay, here is called submit. I've named it image. The class, it's a submit. The value is a submit. But what I've done is I've added this little bit of code to the end. Okay, this bit of code. What this is this is going to be the link to our image what we named Go. Okay, so it's in the folder called images and it's called Go. You remember we just made it inside of Photoshop. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to control X that and take that out, and I'm going to delete this top one and I'm going to put our own code in. So basically it's pretty much exactly the same. At the end of it, we made a link and it linked it to our pictures folder, to our images folder, and it found our picture called Go. Now, when we actually come into the design view, you'll notice that ugly submit button's gone, and there is our button. It's looking damn good. So let's preview this quickly and have a look. There it is. There is our Go button that we made inside of Photoshop, looking very nice. So what I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to stop it here, because this is going to be another tutorial, because what we need to do now is we need to come in and we need to format this so this white box moves over and this Go button moves down and we can make it look good. And I also want to put our own style text in the actual box. So take it easy, guys and girls. That's it for this tutorial. In the next one, we'll come back and finish off this search bar. Laters, everyone.